Hello friends, in this video I am going to solve a different problem on 3D force coupled system, and if you have watched my previous video on this topic then you will find this problem super easy, and so I urge you to pause the video and solve this problem on your own, and once you finish come back here to review the solution along with me. Right, so let's take a look at the data provided in the problem. There are five different force coupled systems acting at different points of this body, and we have to find which of these is equivalent to the force coupled system of 50 newtons force and this moment acting at point O. Now I have a question for you. Can you tell me only by visual inspection as to which of these systems is not equivalent to this force coupled system acting at point O? You don't have to do any calculation. You have to merely inspect or carefully examine these force coupled systems acting at different points and tell me which one is not equivalent to this force coupled system. So feel free to pause the video and do a thorough checking. So I hope you have finished your checking and you have come up with an answer of option F. Why do I say that this option is not equivalent to this force coupled system? The reason is that the force acting at this point F is in Z direction, while the force coupled system at O has a force in X direction. So they are not compatible. And therefore, option F is incorrect. Recall that if there is a body and there is a force acting at point A and you want to shift the point of application of this force to another point, let's say B, then the direction and magnitude of the force has to be the same. And you have to add a couple of moment MB, which is equivalent to the moment of force F about point B. But the direction and magnitude of this force does not change when its point of application is shifted from A to B. So for the same reason, when you shift this force coupled system from point F to point O, the force will remain in the same direction, that is in Z direction, while the desired force is in X direction. So this is not compatible, or this is not equivalent. Right? So let's make a note of it. So option F is incorrect and is ruled out. Now let us examine the force coupled system acting at point G. Okay? So the force is 50 newtons in X direction, so when it gets transferred to point O, it remains in X direction, so it will be 50 newtons I direction. And what is the moment of this 50 newtons force about point O? Well, it should be zero, because this force is lying on the X axis and it will pass through origin, so its moment about point O will be zero. So it will be 0 plus, there are two couples acting at point G. So these two couples will get shifted as they are to point O. So we shall have moments due to these couples, 22.5 J plus 22.5 I Newton meter. Does it match with this? No, this is 22.5 J plus 22.5 K, not I. So this moment is not compatible with this. So this force coupled system acting at G is also not equivalent to this force coupled system. So let's make a note of it. So option G also is incorrect and is ruled out. And now we'll examine the option of force coupled system acting at point I. Okay? So the force here is 50 I newtons. Let us compute the moment M at O because of this force and because of the shifting of these two couples. So let's first write down the couples which get shifted to point O. So we have this 22.5 newton meter in y direction. So we have 22.5 J, and another couple we have in minus z direction. So that will be minus 7.5 K. And what shall be the moment of this 50 newton force about point O? Note that this force is parallel to x-axis, so it will have no moment about the x-axis. This force also intersects the y-axis, so it will not have any moment about the y-axis. But it certainly will have a moment about the z-axis. And if you extend the line of action of this force like this, you will be able to better visualize. Thus, this force will have a moment in this direction. If you see from this direction, you will find that the moment is in clockwise direction. It is like this. And the moment magnitude would be equal to 50 times this distance, which is 0.3 meters. So we will have the moment of minus 50 times 0.3 newton meter because of the moment of this force about point O. This would work out to 15 newton meter, and therefore this will be equal to 22.5 J minus 7.5, and this is minus 15, so minus 22.5 K newton meter. But this is not the same as this. Here we have plus 22.5 K, and here we have minus 22.5 K. So these two are not compatible, or they are not equivalent. So the option I also is incorrect. So this option is incorrect. And now let us examine the force coupled system acting at point D. The force is in x direction. So we have this force as 50 I newtons. And the same force with the same magnitude and direction will get transferred to point O. Now let us check the moment about point O, MO. These two couples at point D will get transferred as they are to point O. So we shall have minus 7.5, minus 7.5 J, and this will be 37.5 K plus 37.5 K, and we shall have moment of this force about point O. Note that this force is parallel to x-axis and therefore will have no moment about the x-axis. Nevertheless, it will have moment about the y-axis and the z-axis. If you extend the line of action of this force backwards, you will be able to better visualize the sense of its moment. It will be like this, and if you look from the top, it will appear to be in counterclockwise. Therefore, we will have plus 50 times 0.6 will be the moment arm. So it will be 50 times 0.6 J, and this will have moment about the z-axis also, and it will be like this, which will appear from this direction in clockwise direction. So it will be minus 50 times, and the moment arm will be so much, which is 0.3. It will be like this. So 50 times 0.3 K. Now this simplified to 30, and this will simplify to 15. So simplify minus 7.5j, and this will be plus 30j, will mean plus 22.5j, and 37.5 minus 15 will mean plus 22.5k Newton meter. So we notice that the force is same as this force, and the moment is 22.5j plus 22.5k, which is same as this. So both force and moments are equal to this, and therefore this is a equivalent force coupled system. So our D option is correct. So let's make a note of that. Now let us examine the force coupled system at A. So the force is 50 Newtons, and the moment is, we have the two couples here, so let's first transfer them to point O. So we have 7.5 J, this moment of the couple, and this is 22.5 K. And now let us examine the moment of this force about point O. So this force is parallel to x-axis, will have no moment about x-axis. This force also intersects the z-axis, therefore will not have any moment about the z-axis, but it will have moment about the y-axis, and it will be like this. And if you see from the top, it will be in counterclockwise direction. And the moment arm will be this distance, which is 0.6 meter. This is equal to 30, so our total will be 37.5 J plus 22.5 K. This certainly is different from this, so option A also is not equivalent to the force coupled system specified here. So we find that out of the five force coupled systems acting at different points on this body, only one of them, that is this force coupled system acting at point D, is equivalent to this specified force coupled system acting at point O. So this is our answer, and we are done. So that's it. Thanks for watching, and I hope you found this tutorial quite useful. And if you liked it, please give your thumbs up. And if you are new to the channel, please consider subscribing to it. Share it with your friends, and thank you for watching this video again. Thank you.